Now it's time to start preparing the legs of the robot. We'll start by installing a servo horn or seat to this upper part of the leg. For this, we'll take out from the back of servo seats, we have four such backs, one of them, the symmetric servo seat or horn. We also will need the two longer screws from the back. They're self-tightening screws. Leave the rest in the back and reseal it for later. Repeat the same with the second back to have everything prepared. Take out this symmetric horn and the two identical longer self-tightening bolts. Leave the rest for later. Take this part, take the horn and place it from between these two parts of the leg here. We can call this part inside part. So place from inside with this sticking part going into this hole and align along this line. Align two of the holes on the horn with the two small holes on the plastic part. Insert a bolt from this side and with a small screwdriver provided by some founder in the kit, start tightening. Make sure the bolt is perpendicular to the surface of the plastic part. Tighten the bolt through the plastic part and the servo horn. Be careful, the bolt is sharp, so if you have your finger like me here, make sure you move it away before the bolt has punctured your finger. Puncturing yourself with sharp objects is never recommended during the robot assembly process. Repeat the same procedure with the second bolt. Make sure you do not keep your finger too long here in order to avoid being punctured. Continue tightening. No need to rush. Take the time to properly insert and tighten the bolt. Do not worry if the part gets slightly deformed in the process. This is normal and will be adjusted once assembling the robot. Repeat the same procedure with the second part. Repeat with the second bolt. and tighten both bolts. Do not worry if the part is slightly deformed in the process. We can manually adjust it a little bit. And furthermore, I believe that it will be straightened once when we mount the rest of the parts of the legs. So here we are. This step is completed for both of these parts of the legs. Now I'll go ahead and install for each leg the foot of the leg to the upper part of the leg. This effectively is part of the foot. This part holds the servo, and here is the foot itself. This part is fully symmetric, so is this one. This means that we can install it fairly freely into this or this hole. The only difference is that when we do the other leg, we have to make sure that the two legs are symmetric. We will also need two conic head M3x8 bolts. I'll take them out of the back. And seal the rest in the back for later. We will also need two self-locking M3 nuts. I'll take them out and seal the back for later. We will insert the bolt through one of these holes here. For the first leg, it doesn't matter which hole we pick, since the leg is symmetric. Next, this leg has two holes, one big one here and a smaller one here. We will insert the bolt through the smaller one, like this. Pick a self-tightening nut and place it on the opposite side, like this. Now we can use a screwdriver, and again I'm using a bigger screwdriver so I can insert it through the bigger hole to tighten. Do not tighten too much. Since the kit includes this wrench, I will try to see if we can use it for this step. And indeed, it's perfect for holding the nut in place. Time to utilize our nice little wrench included in the set. We need to keep this joint loose, but not too loose. So I carefully keep tightening to make sure the joint still moves, but it is not too loose. At the moment, I think it is good enough. Now it's time to repeat the same procedure with the other leg. Take the bolt, make sure we do it symmetric so the two legs will be symmetric to each other. So for this purpose, we will insert it into this hole like this. This way the two legs are exactly symmetric. to each other. Insert through this hole, place the nut. Use our wrench and a screwdriver to tighten the bolt. And make sure we do not over tighten, but don't keep it also very loose. So we have nice smooth joint without too much wiggle. I am happy with the joint now. Our two legs are starting to take shape. Now I'll go ahead and finish the assembly of the two heads. For this, we'll use the already assembled plate and this big head piece. The pieces are not symmetric, so be careful how you assemble them. As you can see, there is this straight part here and this curved part. The straight part will have to be on the inside of the robot. So for this, we'll take this leg, and since the two pieces are not symmetric, we have to decide which one we'll use. As you can see, there is this conic hole here, smaller on this side and bigger on this side. So we have to position it in such a way that the conic part faces down. This side is facing front. This is the front of the robot and the foot. And we need the curved side on this bigger space here. So obviously this is the wrong foot. We'll take the other one, place it here with the conic part on the bottom, so it has to look exactly like this. Take for each foot two conic bolts, M3x8, so we'll need four of them. We have two spares, leave them in the back. And we'll need two per foot, one for each bolt, four all together, corresponding nuts M3. They're self-locking, though we'll not need this feature in this case. Taking them out of the back, again there are two spares. Putting the back aside. Inserting the bolts from the bottom of the foot on the wider side of the hole, so the bolt enters flush with its conic head. Inserting through the corresponding hole here, making sure that the servo seat or horn is on the front as shown on the picture. Placing the nut on the bolt and using a screwdriver. In this case, I will use a slightly different screwdriver. And the conveniently included in the set wrench. Tighten. For now, tighten loosely, so we can easily insert the second bolt. Repeat the same with the second bolt. Place the nut tighten, use the wrench, and now we can go ahead and tighten the two bolts completely. Our foot is fully assembled. We only need to install the servo. Here we have a fully assembled right foot. Now it's time to repeat the same procedure with the other foot. Again, place the leg like this, with the servo seat or horn pointing forward toward the toes. The curved side here opposite to the horn. Insert a bolt from the bottom through both the foot and the leg. Place a nut, tighten loosely, repeat with the second bolt and nut. And use the wrench and a screwdriver to fully tighten once both bolts and nuts are in place. The two legs appear to be fully assembled. We only need to install the servos.